The federal minister who led the battle against COVID and another who faced a rape controversy are tonight preparing to quit politics. Greg Hunt will make a farewell speech in Parliament tomorrow, while former Attorney General Christian Porter has fired a parting shot on his way out.
An Attorney General accused of rape.
Nothing in the allegations that have been printed ever happened.
Christian Porter denied the claim that dated back to his university days.
Just imagine for a second that it's not true.
He took defamation action and questions over who paid his legal bills led to his resignation from Cabinet. Now he's quitting politics and taking aim at those he says brought him down. Perhaps the only certainty now is that there appears to be no limit to what some will say or allege or do to gain an advantage over a perceived enemy. He's not the only senior government figure to call time, Health Minister Greg Hunt gracing centre stage.
Minister for Health has the call.
For one of the last times as he prepares to bow out at the next election.
Closing of the borders to China is as large a decision as any Australian has taken in peacetime since the Second World War.
A 20-year parliamentary career that saw him be Minister for the Environment, Industry and Sport before turning to health. Ambitious and tenacious, Greg Hunt was a key figure in ousting Malcolm Turnbull as Prime Minister.
The Prime Minister has my support.
Often divisive, he survived the political fallout and a bruising election campaign before the world was hit by COVID.
We're not immune, but we are as well prepared as any country in the world.
Criticism came his way over vaccine deals and the initial slow pace of the rollout. Today, those close to him gave a dose of thanks.
We are very, very dear friends, and he's been an outstanding health minister through this crisis.
Neither resignation came as a surprise, but they both create a significant challenge for the government to find the right candidates as it seeks re-election. Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.